Hello, my name is Mikael Lyck and I'm going to do a video review of the latest issue of Fantomen. It's number 24 in 2018. And it's a pretty spectacular issue since it has a story done by 8 different artists. It also has a great poster of the inside of the skull cave. And the filler story is Fantomen Kids, so that's all great. So let's open this up. So it starts here with the editor-in-chief telling us about how he got inspiration to order this story by remembering when he was younger reading the American comic Uncanny X-Men issue 273, where it's also a joint venture between lots of different artists. So he thought it could be done with Fantomen, and as we soon will see, it's really nice. And then in this question and answer section, it's actually my question there from Facebook. That's pretty nice. A nice coincidence that it ended up in this great issue. So I'm gonna wait with talking about the main story and go past it. Here is the, like, we usually have few pages of facts. So this is like facts about weather in Fantomen, since this issue is a lot about the weather and different stories. It's have been main actor in the story, the weather. And then there's some facts about the color of the costume, like the gray ghost that Lee Falk originally thought it would be. And then it's the blue Scandinavian colors and the purple American colors and the Latin red ones, and some information about why these colors could be, why they originated like they did. Then we have this Fantomens värld that is the art is pretty old school, but I really like it. I love this art style, and actually pretty funny page. I hope they continue doing this. Really nice. And then we have the Fantomen Kids. Not to be confused by the Kid Phantom that the Fru is giving out. Kid Phantom is about the 21st Phantom when he was young, and this is about Kit and Heloise, so the 22nd Phantom when the time comes. But this is now time, so not yet. And I really love the art style of this one. It's very comic and light and bright. And I mean, it's a nice story about, or it's a story about poachers, but it's nice. And it's written by Mikael Sol, so the editor-in-chief, and the art is actually done by Jan Bielecki. I'm not good at pronouncing names. I hope you know who I mean when I say this. This picture is nice, really nice. Yeah, and it almost gets the same amount of pages as the main story, which is also nice, because then they really can flesh out the story. And from what I'm hearing, the next year it's gonna be a collection of this Fantomen Kid story in a book, trade paperback maybe. It's gonna be nice. Then there's some story about the next issue. Seems to be only reprints, but it's a double issue, probably only Phantom, so that's also gonna be nice. Then in the middle we have this great poster of the Skull Cave, the insides. I really wanted it at least twice this size, and I mean, I don't particularly like that it's gonna be holes when you take it out of the comic book, but I guess we'll have to live with it. I don't know why they cut this room in half. It's the Roman tomb, but maybe we're not supposed to see exactly what's in there. Maybe this indicates that there are might be more rooms in the future that we don't know. Yeah, but all in all, it's a really nice image. I would, maybe they could have stickers, we put in more rooms if they have it in stories. Yeah, I like it. So let's go to the main story then. So here it is, written by Andreas Eriksson. It's his first endeavor as a writer for Fantom. And if you're a big Fantom fan or Swedish book comic fan, then you probably know of him. He has done a lot for the community and a lot for Fantom. Well, this is the main thing. It's 8 different artists, and they change every 3 pages. So we're gonna look at all the transitions. So everything has been spoilers, but this will be even more spoilers. So it starts out there with Salveluto for 3 pages here and inside the skull cave. I really like the silhouette of Guron here. It's very nice done. And then they start reading a story, and we get into Einar Bade's 3 pages. As you can see, it's totally different. It's very red, and because of this blood rain. And it really stands out from the previous pages. When the story ends and we get back to the skull cave, it's a new artist again. Here it's Alex Saviuk. There you go. I think Alex and Sal's styles, at least in the skull cave, are pretty close to each other. Can't really see big differences there. Of course there's differences, but pretty nice. And since we read 3 different pages in between, it's even harder to tell the difference. And then they go to the school, and it's Joan Boix who did the art for these pages. And it's clearly different venue. Nice transition to the new artist. And then she starts telling the story. And that story is artist by Kari Leppänen. Yeah, and that story ends here. And now they're back in the skull cave, and it's Carlos Pedrazzini that's writing this one, or doing the art for this one's really nice. And here we go over to the next artist. This is the smallest transition because they're basically in the same place. So here it's the easiest place to see that there's 2 different artists, and you can clearly see different styles of doing art here, and I think that's pretty nice to see that in the comic, since that's what it's all about. So here César Spadari starts doing his pages, and it ends here with him running away. And then we have this nightmarish vision that Rafael Ruiz is doing, and then it ends here. And if I'm really going into spoilers here, this villain, he has this powder that makes Fantom forget about him, so he would be a really good reoccurring villain, since every time then they could just say, oh well, you thought you killed him, but it was only the powder that make you think that, and they could reuse him forever almost. And it's a very nice story. The script is really done for the 8 different artists, because they're changing venue so frequently, and it makes a great overall thing. I don't think you could take any script and just put 8 different artists and try to pull it out. I don't think that would be very good at all, but with this script it really works. And I think that was everything. Yes, thank you for watching this video review. It's a gray dawn.